I'm J.R. Fox, the Division Chief of Operations for the Campbell County Fire Department. Campbell County is in northeast Wyoming. We cover a little over 4,800 square miles. So with these trucks, really what we're looking at and why we chose SVI and when we worked with their design team was a lot of our stations were built 30 years ago. Back then, the trucks were longer. They had the single cab with top mount pump panels. And when we went to replace these apparatus, we found that they wouldn't accommodate the trucks of 2019-20 that are considerably longer with the custom cabs. So we chose similar to a Type 3 model. These trucks actually meet Type 1 requirements for ISO. And we're able to kind of incorporate the urban interface, which is where these trucks will be stationed, urban interface, still able to perform structural fires and rescue as well, but really the urban interface was kind of the focus. These have pump and roll, and we're able to put a 750-gallon tank on them to meet the needs of the communities they're going to serve. We chose the Freightliner chassis because majority of our fleet is Freightliner, and we've been attempting to standardize our fleet, so we chose a Freightliner chassis, four-wheel drive. In Wyoming, obviously, we have conditions that require four-wheel drive where these apparatus are going to be stationed. We also chose to go with only two air pack positions in the rear and allow for more storage inside the cab with the doghouse to keep a lot of our instruments temperature controlled. So a lot of what we focused on was the overall length, again, to meet our needs and to be able to place these apparatus in some older stations. The pump panel, we chose to go with electronic valves, again, to save on the overall length. Cleans up the pump panel configuration internally, which our mechanics really enjoy. We chose to go with the longer cabinet on both sides so that we're able to store some wildland tools, something we hadn't previously been able to do with our conventional apparatus. For the first time, we've done the air primer, which the pneumatic primer, which we think is going to be advantageous from a mechanical standpoint, and it's a more reliable primer for us. The pump is a 1,000 GPM. Again, we were able to put 750 gallons on this apparatus, which is pretty standard for our organization. TFT inlets on both sides, so again, we were able to standardize our trucks, but still be able to do a multi-role with this piece of apparatus. So with the standardization, again, on our apparatus, above the wheel wells is where we keep our forcible entry tools. SVI builds tool backer boards at a reasonable rate compared to pack tracks. So this panel just simply removes and you can put brackets that'll mount directly to those panels, which allows our folks in-house to do that. So we've really enjoyed that concept. Some of these rear compartments are fairly deep. SVI, we've also purchased a couple of their smaller gas fans, so we're able to do put some ventilation fans in these compartments that we normally wouldn't be able to do just because of the size of some of the larger fans. So the center of gravity of these trucks and the overall height, we were a little bit concerned about bedding hose, deploying hose. So SVI has a solution for that with this ladder that simply folds down. It has several lights, so at night, low light conditions, it's lit up well for our folks. We also have a hose bed cover that's electric that allows us to open the hose bed cover, to rebed hose and do anything that we need to do up above the bumper. We also have a bracket that's stored internally but can be pinned that allows us to deploy and store forestry hose so that we're in the urban interface environment and we're moving from house to house. We're able to quickly throw the hose on the apparatus, reposition, and then redeploy. So the overall height of this truck, we were concerned about how we were going to access our ladder storage. We did increase the size of the tank, so an internal ladder storage wasn't really an option. So SVI has a pretty nice system for deploying the ladder rack. And this will allow all of our folks to access ground ladders, some of our longer hooks, and some hard suction hose at a reasonable height. The other thing we're able to incorporate into this truck that's new to our organization was a decontamination shower. This shower head, it's recirculated water through the pump, so it allows a warm shower for our folks that can decontaminate some of the gross particles after a fire. We also incorporated a 1-inch booster reel underneath the steps. Again, this just saves us space and allows for fairly easy and quick deployment. So in order to standardize our apparatus, all of our Class A or Type 1 pumpers, we deploy an 1¾-inch 100-foot bumper load. So it was important for us to keep all of our apparatus as standardized as possible while going with this newer chassis design. So we were able to extend the bumper and have the ability to deploy and rebed from the bumper with these apparatus. We also were able to add a brow light on top, all LED on this apparatus, simply for those nights and those times where we need extra light on scene or responding.